So I want to divide this talk cum workshop into six sections. Firstly, we're going to talk about what a display server is. Then I want to talk about how we can start a redundant user interface using Xorg. Then some talk about window manager, how the GTK toolkit and the Qt toolkit works, and desktop environments and login numbers. So since we've already wasted 30 minutes, let's just start. So basically, a display server is very similar to a web server. So basically what happens is, imagine an Apache server. You have your server, you have your HTTP protocol, and you have your client. The server would send some instructions, some files through the protocol, and then the client, which is your web browser usually, would render what those instructions in those files were saying. So the display server in Linux works a lot like that. You have your server, which interacts with your hardware, which interacts with your GPU, and sends instructions through a mystery protocol, which I won't talk about right now. But your server sends instructions through a protocol, and there is another piece of software, like a web browser, called your client, which would render them. So currently the protocol through which this information is sent is the X protocol, and the latest version is the 11th. So you might have heard people talk about X11. That's what they're referring to when they actually say X11. It's the 11th version of the X protocol. So your server sends the information through the X protocol. Okay, so there is a pretty interesting result of this separation of a display server and a display client. What you can do is, if you have a display server running on this machine, say, and this machine is also an SSH server, you can use SSH to receive commands from this machine, and then on your computer, display client would take those commands and render them on your machine. So the application would be running on some other machine, and your machine would actually render that that application. One trade-off of this is that, since you have a server and a client running on the same machine, if you're not, sending your application through an SSH protocol or something, then that creates some overhead on your computer. So there are other protocols like WAN and stuff which are trying to fix this. So now that you have a basic idea of what the display server and the client is, we're actually going to try and do something. So how many of you have this virtual machine setup? Okay, how many of you have the actual OVA file? So you can pass this around and switch again. Yeah. Anyone needs the OVA file? Okay.
So if who doesn't have this, open the IP address 192.100.30.161.
Yeah. I don't think it would be much faster.
It's the same network.
192. Fast means slow.
Yeah,
I mean,
Sure. उनके एरर्स आ रहे हैं, फेल टू इंपोर्ट हो गए,
से कॉपी नहीं हुई,
कॉपी नहीं है तो फिर से कॉपी कर लो।
वीएमवेयर यूज कर रहे हो क्या? वो
नहीं, वर्चुअल मशीन से वर्चुअल ऑफिस यूज कर रहे
हैं। वीएमवेयर पास नहीं कर रहा है,
The display server I was talking about, currently Xorg is the most popular display server running. Wayland is trying to fix that. So let's just try and create a redundant user interface. So if you have your Arch Linux virtual machine set up, then okay, so do you guys have this .xinitrc file? जिन जिन इससे बड़ा नहीं होगा ना वर्चुअल मशीन है।
उसे मैं इसका लॉगिन आईडी पासवर्ड तो होगा,
यूज़ नहीं कर रहा हूँ। कंट्रोल है।
फाइन। उससे भी लेकिन बड़ा नहीं होता ना।
तो सेम तो कर रहे हैं। वही तो कर रहे हैं।
फाइन।
स्केलिंग ऑप्शन आप लास्ट करने लगे।
अभी जा। स्केलिंग करेंगे आप।
देन जस्ट स्केलिंग ऑप्शन।
हाँ, मैंने स्केलिंग ऑप्शन ट्राई करा था।
उसके बाद आप ड्रैग करो उसको। साइज तो
आप करो स्केलिंग।
ओके सबको दिख रहा है। ओके सो दिस ओके सो टू बेसिकली स्टार्ट बेसिक यूजर इंटरफेस यू वांट टू ओपन अप दिस .xinitrc फाइल एंड यू वांट टू जस्ट टाइप इन दिस वन लाइन स्क्रिप्ट। सो व्हाट दिस बेसिकली डज इज व्हेन यू गोना एग्जीक्यूट द स्क्रिप्ट बाय टाइपिंग स्टार्ट x, the command will look for the script in your home folder and then it will set the proper display variable. So xln has to be told which display to open up the display server on. So if you just do this, give it a second, and okay, yeah. So this is like ancient window manager. We're going to talk about window manager. This is an ancient user interface. It was, I think, conceived in 1984 or something. And this was, this is called TWN, Tom's window manager, which I prefer. X7 calls it the tab window manager. But basically this was like one of the first window managers ever to exist. So you can, this is basic functionality. You can click on the desktop and you can open up terminals. That's about it. So this will tell you where to open up the terminal, and yeah, that's about it. This is all it does. So let's just quit this display. Yeah, so that just killed the X11 server. Now okay, so let's talk about now window managers. So when I actually did this, so you can see that it's gonna ask you where to open up this window. So a window manager is pretty much what it does, what it says. It manages windows. So it's gonna start these window decorations. It's gonna give you those window decorations. It's gonna allocate screen real estate to the application. So if I have two separate applications open, if I open up another terminal over this, so the window manager knows which one is in focus. So that's what I was talking about by allocating screen real estate. But this is a common misconception. The window manager does not fill in the windows. It'll just give you an empty border, and the application has to fill inside in the windows. Okay, so now this is what's called as a stacking window manager. So you can see that these two windows are overlapping, so it's gonna stack two windows on top of each other if you know their coordinates overlap. There is a better way to manage windows in my opinion, so I'm gonna quickly show you that. Okay, so I've installed it on your systems too. Let's get out of this. And
when you try to create a new window, it shows certain grid lines. Do they have any significance? Can you do something with grid lines, or it just shows like?
So it's gonna, it's just indicating which area of the screen is going.
It does not show a single square. Just
So that doesn't have any significance. Okay, so now we're gonna install. A new window manager called i3. So to install it, you can type in this command on your machine: patman -s i3. So I've actually downloaded all the packages. I just wanted to show you the installation procedure and everything, which is why I don't have everything installed. I just have all the, packages downloaded. So it's gonna install everything, and now we can. So now we can edit this file again. We are telling X11 to start the tab window manager, Tom's window manager. We can simply change that by just telling it to start i3. That's it. Now I can type in start X, and this is i3. So this is gonna ask you if you wanna create a configuration. So it'll auto-generate a configuration. This is, don't worry about this that much right now. So before, windows were stacking on top of each other. Windows were taking each other's screen real estate. Now you can open up a terminal, hopefully. So one question was,
Control Alt F2.
Okay, perfect. So
mirror.
So this is the RC configuration. I'm just going to change the super key to
set mod of alt.
Alt. Finally, okay. Back to i3. कुछ लोगों का काम नहीं कर रहा है. Once again, not sure क्यों नहीं. I'm just trying to reboot the system, so you can just type in reboot and it should work then.
कर रहा है.
I'm not sure.
इसका तो नहीं पड़ा. मेरा.
i3 काम नहीं कर रहा
होगा. Shift.
Type in reboot to reboot the actual.
Window plus mod enter. Super key to center. आपके terminal पर.
Yeah, so one question that DK asked was that can we just pass in i3 as a parameter to StarX? You can always do that, but here's the thing, you can do a lot more interesting stuff with the XNET RC. So basically what happens is, the XNET RC is entirely a bash script. StarX basically just set some variables for you, like the display variable. So if you have this working, you can type in $display. And this is something that StarX set. So one interesting thing you can do is you can have an environment variable. So for instance, if I type in WM equals, so if I want to switch between TWM and i3 whenever I want, so I don't have to always edit the XNET RC. I can, for instance, set up this WM environment variable, and then I can do this. So this will set the window manager to TWM, and then it will execute the StarX command. But you have to actually script that into your XNET RC, which I'm not going to do right now. This is something I did on his laptop, if you don't know this. Okay, so right now i3, before when you opened up a terminal in TWM, it took up some amount of screen real estate. This time in i3, it took up the whole screen. Well, almost the whole screen. You can get rid of this bar if you don't want it. What happens if I open up another terminal? It tiles next to it. And you can open up any number of terminals you want, they're gonna tile next to each other. Now you don't always have to tile them one against the other, you can tile them vertically and everything. And i3 also has a pretty great configuration setup, so you can always create your own custom shortcuts and everything. So yeah, this is in my opinion a much better way to manage Windows, because firstly, it will take up almost all of your screen real estate, so none of the screen real estate will be going to something like your taskbar or your window borders. You can get rid of everything and just your windows if you want. Secondly, this is completely keyboard driven, so if you program a lot, you can use this to, you know, you can easily switch between windows, so you can see which window is highlighted and everything. You can switch windows around, and it also gives you like 10 workspaces, and you can do pretty much almost a lot with it. So I won't go into that right now because we're already running late. Yeah, so let's just kill this. Yeah, so what's next? More information about i3, you can either come to me after this talk, or you can talk to TK. Yeah, talk to TK. Yeah. Okay. So far we've only talked about window managers, which do nothing but place windows on the screen. To actually create windows with buttons and everything, you have to use a widget toolkit. So how many of you have designed user interfaces here? Even Android, anything. Yeah. So some of you have. So usually when you design user interfaces, you have to place buttons and everything. So when you design user interfaces for computers, you also have to do stuff like that. So I have an example set up. So, oops. Okay. So I have this app installed, app downloaded called Glade. So this is an app you can use to rapidly develop apps for Linux. Rapidly develop graphical apps for Linux. It's called Glade. and I'll show you how it works. Let's start up the Excel once again. I'm gonna open up the terminal and run it. So yeah. Oops. This full screen. Yeah, so this is great. You can always, let me show you. You can, so firstly you have, you have a top level window. Notice that this window does not have borders. Glade knows that other window managers will take care of the borders, the screen, real estate and everything. Glade will only give you these top windows to actually, you know. So firstly you have your top level window. Then you're gonna have a container in it. So let me see if I can do that right now. Let's add a container over here. Just quickly gonna show you this. If this works. Okay, so anyway, you have your container, so it's going to divide the widget up into, for instance, this will divide the widget vertically, the screen the app vertically, and then you can place buttons and everything inside that. So this is the
install करना पड़ता है ना? बहुत लोगों ने i3 install नहीं किया, so Pacman minus is i3 करो.
Yeah, okay.
इसलिए बहुत अच्छा नहीं चल रहा.
अगर ये वर्चुअल मशीन चले तो मैं दिखा दूँ फिर से इंस्टॉल कैसे करना
है एक्स रिसोर्सेज से भी होता है और या फिर एक्स डिफॉल्ट से भी होता है
toolkit, so you can place stuff in here. So for instance, I can place a minibar up top. I can place. Here, you can bind stuff, you can bind events of this function to actual functions in your source code. So, and almost all of this is handled graphically. So you have signals over here and you can tell the tell it which function will handle when this button is clicked. So, yeah, basically I just wanted to show you quickly how graphical interfaces created using the toolkit. Now this toolkit, this all of these widgets are provided by something called GTK. GTK is created by the GNOME Foundation. GNOME, however you want to call it.
GNOME.
It's an acronym, so I prefer to call it GNOME.
It's actually GNOME, in the GNOME website.
You cannot call
GNOME.
You want
to
call it GNOME.
Anyway, yeah, so this is, I just want to quickly show you how graphical interfaces. So, sab log ka I3 chal gaya. I3 mein agar aapko wo karna hai, brain khola hai, aapne मेटा की जो विंडोज की है उसको सेट कर रखा है क्या? So okay, let's do that one again. Okay, so okay, so when you started I3, this must have showed up. You want to press enter and you want to select alt. Don't select the Windows key because VirtualBox doesn't like that. So select alt and just press enter. Now this has, now if you want to open up a terminal, you just type in alt and enter, that will open up a terminal. If you want to open up blade, on the terminal just type in blade. If you want to make the blade window full screen, just alt and F. It's pretty simple, you can set your own shortcuts and everything. The configuration file is over here, .config, i3, config. You can edit that however you want. I'm going to move on for it. So let's exit i3. Okay, so far I've talked about how the XO works, I've talked about XORG and X11. I showed you Window Manager and I showed you how the toolkits work. There's another toolkit called Qt, pretty great. Windows uses it, so if you create something in Qt, the UI will work on both Windows and Linux, I'm pretty sure.
Everywhere, even in mobile.
Mobile, maybe Qt is good. Pretty great. Okay, yeah, Kiwi is better. Anyway. Anyway, so now, finally now, usually when you use something like Ubuntu or Windows or anything, you have your taskbar and everything on screen. What do you do if you want to do that? So now, so far you have just seen like plain Windows. What do you want to do if you want a full user interface? Now, these are called desktop environments. So for a desktop environment, basically just takes in all of this stuff, adds some tweaks on it, like a menu bar, some actual menus on the menu bar, file menus in it. I'm gonna stop talking about menus anyway. So I've talked about. So I've downloaded two of the granddaddies of desktop environments, KDE Plasma and GNOME. Whichever one you want to install it, you can do it. I'm going to show you the commands for both. So if you want to install GNOME, you just type in. If you can type in. Yeah. So you just type in Pacman. How many of you understand what Pacman is, by the way? It's the actual package manager. On Ubuntu, you have apt-get and stuff like that. If you want to translate this into Ubuntu Stream, you would replace this by apt-get, you would replace this by install, and this is the actual package you're installing. So let's install GNOME. And if you want to install Plasma, just type in Plasma. That's it. Whichever one you want to install, it's up to you. So. Yeah, happy you are. That's the actual install. Anyway, it's gonna pull all of the stuff. Just type an enter code every thing it asks. It's just gonna install that. काम करो आप लोग जो जो फॉलो ऑन कर रहे हो क्या कर रहे हो सब कुछ समझ आ रहा है
आप इंस्टॉल क्या कर रहे हो पीछे क्यूटी
नहीं सो अभी मैं GNOME डेस्कटॉप में इंस्टॉल So, सब लोगों ने विंडो मैनेजर्स वगैरह ट्राई आउट करे अभी तक हाँ ये दिखाना दिखा सकते हैं स्टार्ट हो गया होपफुली वर्चुअल मशीन क्रैश
देखे राजू भैया बोल रहे
कौन बुला रहा है
इधर इधर
आई
लेट नो
आई डिस्टर्ब मुझे बहुत सारे
So, GNOME usually uses the GTK toolkit, Plasma uses the Qt toolkit to fill in the widget. So, Plasma has good theming and everything for Qt. GNOME has good theming for GTK. And this should be top done. Okay, so in case you install Plasma, I will tell you how to use Startex to start the Plasma desktop. Currently, you're telling XNRS to start i3. To start with the GNOME session, you just type in GNOME session. If you wanted to start Plasma, KD Plasma, you type in exec start KD. KD, yes, Plasma would start up only the Plasma desktop. So start KD would start up a bunch of the sessions with Plasma. Okay, so I'll start GNOME, so let's start GNOME. सब लोग फॉलो ऑन कर पा रहे हो कर
नहीं ऑप्शन क्या है वो लॉगिन के बाद
If it's asking you to select some packages, just type in enter twice or thrice and it will install it. Okay. कॉम एक्चुअली इंस्टॉल कर रही है ओके कंटिन्यू करो ओके सो वंस अगेन यू वांट टू जस्ट टाइप इन स्टार्ट एक्स टू स्टार्ट द GNOME ऑपरेशन Okay, fine. So this how many of you have used the latest Ubuntu? Ubuntu, Debian, anything. How many of you have used Ubuntu GNOME or something like Fedora, OpenSUSE, anything?
Debian.
Yep.
यूनिटी
बनाया था ठीक है सर उन्होंने ये इस पे ऐसे नोट करते या फिर
This is not how it should look like.